Hey guys, welcome back to the Wozanazo Transfer Show. On today's episode, we have Thembi Kosi Lorch wanting out at Orlando Pirates. Mamelodi Sundowns unveil George Maluleka. And Kaizer Chiefs Samir Nurkovic wants a Bafana Bafana collab. Right before we get into the episode, please don't forget to smash that subscribe button and turn on all your notifications so you are always up to date with the latest PSL news. We kick off the episode in PE as Chipper United part ways with former Orlando Pirates winger. Rahale's future has been the subject of speculation over the past few months after it emerged that Kaizer Chiefs were looking to sign him. Chipper United have released the following statement. Thabo Rahale's contract has expired and we can confirm that the club and Thabo have amicably parted ways. Rahale is one of the latest players to add a long list of aging PSL players without clubs. Could the skillful winger find a club at the age of 30? Please let me know in the comments below. Our next story takes us to Highlands Park as the Lions of the North extend Mahaula deal. Mokete Mahaula has been handed his Highlands Park contract extension, as the players' representatives have confirmed. Mahaula has renewed his contract with Highlands Park by a further 2 years with an option to extend. Highlands Park believe Mahaula could emulate the same achievements with the likes of Bafana Bafana international stars in Thembi Kosi Lorch and Percy Tau. Talking of Thembi Kosi Lorch, we move out to Orlando Pirates, with Lorch seemingly being unhappy being at Orlando Pirates. The Orlando Pirates star Thembi Kosi Lorch has come out and commented on the current situation at Orlando Pirates, and Lorch says missing out on a move to Europe still hurts him up till this day. It was widely reported that Lorch had plenty of foreign suitors following his performance in the 2018-2019 season, which earned him the PSL Player Footballers Award. Having confirmed there was big interest from Belgium, Turkey and France, he further admitted that the move didn't materialize as clubs failed to meet Pirates' demands, which ultimately affected his performances on the pitch. After playing AFCON, I thought it was my chance to go and play overseas and make my dream come true. The offers were there, but those people didn't offer Pirates the money they were expecting. But certainly the offers were there. I was disappointed I couldn't go overseas because I see players leaving Pirates for overseas like Lyle Frostler and Marshall Munensi. So it really hurt me to see Munensi and Frostler playing in France. Sometimes I ask myself, what's wrong with me? What's preventing me from playing overseas? I still wish to play overseas because it's my dream, and it's also my parents' dream to see me playing overseas. This is a clear and precise message to Orlando Pirates and to any foreign teams that still have interest in Lorch. It seems that Thembi Kosi Lorch is ready to move and leave Orlando Pirates, and this could be the last season we see Nyoso in the black and white of the ghost. Could he get his supposed move to Europe? Please let me know in the comments below if you think Thembi Kosi Lorch should leave and Orlando Pirates should let him go if the player is not happy being at the club. From Orlando Pirates, we move all the way to Mamelodi Sundowns as Sundowns wrap up vets striker deal. Giff Mutupa's proposed move to Mamelodi Sundowns will be finalized soon. According to a source privy to the situation, the deal is good as done as the Brazilians and Bidvest Wits have reached an agreement this week. Mutupa has been discussing personal term with the Tshwane Giants. There's a deal in principle, but until he puts pen to paper, we cannot say the deal is done. We expect him to finalize everything with Sundowns by next week. They are the only team that has been talking to him at this stage. The 24-year-old marksman is said to be offered a 5-year deal, which will be split into a 3-year contract with an option to renew with a further 2 years. Mutupa will have to compete with the likes of Mauricio Alfonso, Lebohang Mabue and Pakamani Mahlambi amongst the attackers at Sundowns. Staying with the Brazilians as Mamelodi Sundowns unveil the new signing of George Maluleka. George Maluleka has been unveiled as a Mamelodi Sundowns player less than 48 hours after Kaizer Chiefs confirmed his release. Mamelodi Sundowns have officially announced the signing of George Maluleka from Kaizer Chiefs. Sundowns are delighted to announce George Maluleka has signed a 3-year contract with the Brazilians. Maluleka will be ineligible to play for the Tshwane Giants as the season has not yet officially been concluded. However, Sundowns confirmed he will continue to train and will be registered with the PSL as soon as the transfer window opens. Maluleka will have to compete with the likes of Tuyani Mabunda, Andile Jali, Hlompho Kekana, and Opa Manyisa. Amongst the players, he'll have to fight for a place in that Sundowns central midfield role. Guys, please let me know if George Maluleka can get into that Sundowns midfield, can get into Piso Musimane's starting 11, and if you think this was a good move for the career of George Maluleka. Our next story takes us to the former employers of George in Kaizer Chiefs, as Chiefs exits and renewals confirmed. Kaizer Chiefs have decided against renewing the contracts of Kabelo Matlasela and Joseph Molangwane. The midfield duo will leave the Naturena-based outfit with immediate effect. Matlasela has left the club and his contract will not be renewed. We wish him all the best at Polokwane City going forward. These were the comments made by a Kaizer Chiefs statement. On the other hand, Molongwane's contract has expired and will not be extended as well. The player has struggled with injuries and it has been rumored that retirement could be a possibility for the now former Amakhosi forward. With Kaizer Chiefs facing a transfer ban, Chiefs have made moves in retaining the services of Spilile Changase and Polani Zulu. The duo of Changase and Zulu have committed themselves to the Naturena Bayside for a further year. Changase expressed his excitement at being afforded another chance to make it and try and make an impression at Naturena. Zulu as well promised to work even harder after being given a second chance. Both players have struggled to get in Ernst Mittendorf's team this season, but with a further contract extension, this could be the light at the end of the tunnel and could see Zulu and Changase really fight for a spot in that starting 11 at Amakhosi. Staying with the Amakhosi faithful is Samir Nurkovic, wants a Bafana Bafana call up. Kaizer Chiefs striker Samir Nurkovic has fallen in love with the country and has expressed his desire to play for Bafana Bafana. Nurkovic joined Chiefs at the start of the 2019-2020 season and quickly established himself as one of the most feared strikers in the PSL, having scored 12 goals in 24 appearances in his debut campaign. The 28-year-old, who has not yet represented the country of his birth, Serbia, at any international senior level, which makes him eligible to play for Bafana Bafana should he continue living in the country and working for the next 5 consecutive years. We could see the possibility of Nurkovic playing alongside his Amakhosi teammates in Lebohang Manyama, Eric Matoho, and Itumeleng Khune at international level. Guys, please let me know in the comments below if you think Coco Tella could make it as a Bafana Bafana international. Yep, guys, this is all we have for the episode. Please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.